Stand and deliver. Drop that gun.
Let that be a warning to you all. You move at your peril, for I have two pistols here. I know one of them isn't loaded anymore, but the other one is, so that's going to be dead for sure. Well, just about for sure, anyway. It certainly wouldn't be worth your while risking it, because I'm a very good shot. I practice every day. Well, not absolutely every day, but most days in the week. I expect I must practice 4 or 5 times a week, at least. At least 4 or 5. Only some weekends, like last weekend, there wasn't much time, so that brings the average down a bit. But I should say it's definitely a solid 4 days practice every week. At least. I mean, I reckon I could hit that tree over there, the one behind the hillock. Not the big hillock, the little hillock on the left. You see the 3 trees? The 3rd from the left and back a bit, that one, I reckon I could hit that 4 times out of 5. On a good day. Say, with this wind, say 7 times out of 10.
Oh, that tree there?
Which one?
The big beech with a sort of bare branch coming out of the top left.
No, no, not that one.
No, no, he means the one over there. Look, do you see that one there?
Yeah.
Well, now go 2 along to the right.
Just near that little bush.
Well, it's the one just behind it.
Oh, the elm.
Oh, that's not an elm. An elm's got sort of great clumps of leaves like that. That's either a beech or a hornbeam.
A hornbeam?
No, not a hornbeam. What's the tree that has a leaf with sort of regular veins coming out, and the veins go all the way out to the...
Serrated
edges.
A willow.
Well, that's right.
That's nothing like a willow.
Well, it doesn't matter anyway. I could hit it 7 times out of 10. That's the point.
Never a willow.
Shut up! It's a hold-up, not a botany lesson. Right now, my fine friends, no false moves, please. I want you to hand over all the lupins you've got.
Lupins?
Yes, lupins. Come on, come on.
What do you mean, lupins?
Don't try and play for time.
I'm not. You mean the flower lupins?
That's right.
Well, we haven't got any lupins.
Honestly?
Look, my fine friends, I happen to know that this is the Lupin Express.
You must be out of your tiny mind.
Get out the coach. Come on, get out! Just as I thought. Not clever enough, my fine friends. Come on, Concord.
Well, so much for the lupins.
Dennis Moore, galloping through the sward. Dennis Moore, and his horse Concord. He steals from the rich and gives to the poor. Mr. Moore.
I'll be back.
Mr. Moore.
But of course, no shirt. Just tis my Lord of Buckingham. Pray welcome, Your Grace.
Thank you, Grantley.
Ladies, may I introduce to you the man who prophesied that a German monarch would soon embroil this country in continental affairs.
Oh, how soon, my Lord?
Madam, you recall that prior to his accession, our gracious sovereign George had become involved in the long-standing Northern War through his claim to Bremen and Verdun. These duchies would provide an outlet to the sea of the utmost value to Hanover. The Treaty of Westphalia has assigned them to Sweden.
In 1648.
Exactly.
Meanwhile, Frederick William of Denmark, taking advantage of the absence of Charles XII, seized them, 1712.
Oh, yeah. It all falls into place. More wine.
Oh, thank you.
However, just prior to his accession, George had made an alliance with Frederick William of Prussia on the grounds of party feeling.
While Frederick William had married George's only daughter.
I remember the wedding.
But chiefly through concern for concerted action against Charles XII.
Stand and deliver!
Dennis Moore!
The same! And now, my lords, my ladies, your lupins, please.
Oh, what?
Come, don't play games with me, my lord of Buckingham.
What can you mean?
Your life or your lupins, my lord? In a bunch. Thank you, my friends. And now, a good evening to you all.
them here. He seeks them there. He seeks those lupins everywhere.
The murdering blackguard. He's taken all our lupins.
Not quite.
Oh, you tricked him.
We still have one.
Dennis Moore, Dennis Moore, riding through the night. Soon every lupin in the land will be in his mighty hand. He steals them from the rich and gives them to the poor. Mr. Moore, Mr. Moore, Mr. Moore.
Try to eat some, my dear. It'll give you strength. Oh, Mr. Moore. Mr. Moore, she's going fast.
Don't worry, I brought you something.
Medicine at last?
No.
Food?
Nope.
Some blankets, perhaps. Mm. Clothes? Wood for the fire?
Nope.
Lupins! Oh, Christ!
Don't you like them?
I'm sick to bloody death of them!
Sandy!
She's bloody died, and all you bring us is lupins.
All we've eaten, mate,
for the last four bleeding weeks is lupin soup. Roast lupin, steamed lupin, braised lupin in lupin sauce, lupin in a basket with sautéed lupins, lupin meringue pie, lupin sorbet. We sit on lupins, we sleep in lupins, we feed the cat on lupins, we burn lupins, we even wear the bloody thing!
Looks very smart.
Oh, shut up! We're sick to death with the stench of them! Look! The cat's just choked itself to death on them! I don't care if I never see another lupin till the day I die! Why don't you go out and steal something useful?
Like what?
Like gold and silver and clothes and wood and jewels.
Hang on, I'll get a piece of paper.
Dennis Moore, Dennis Moore, dum 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 the night. Dennis Moore, dum 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 the fight. He steals dum 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 and dum dum dum. Dennis dum, Dennis dum dum dum.
And this, are covered with the presence of Peter and his Prussians in Mecklenburg, and Charles and his Swedes in Pomerania, made George and Stanhope eager to come to terms with France.
Meanwhile, a breach had opened with a... Oh, no, not again.
Oh, come
stand
on.
And deliver again. Your money, your jewellery, your... Your clothes, your snuff, your ornaments, your glassware, your pussycats.
Don't say anything about the lupin.
Your watches, your lace, your spittoon.
Dennis Moore, Dennis Moore, riding through the woods. Dennis Moore, with a bag of things. He gives to the poor and he takes from the rich. Dennis Moore, Dennis Moore.
Here we are.
Dennis Moore.
Well, it may be the end of that, but it's certainly far from the end of... Well, in fact, it's the beginning.